So, dear colleagues, the topic of my presentation is involvement of contact and surface phenomena in nanolayered amorphous room films for toxic gas detection at room temperature. The authors are me, Mocreac, and Branişte. All we are from technical university, from different research centers. Contents of presentation. Firstly, I will show the sensor principle and design, material characterization, gas sensing categorization, and sensing mechanism. And I will finish with some conclusions. So, the high sensitivity of tellurium films to nitrogen dioxide attracts special attention because it's very toxic gas, which can cause diseases of the respiratory system, necrotic changes in the liver, kidneys, and brain. That's why its concentration in different countries is limited. For instance, in the United States, it's 3 ppm, in 250 ppb, and Japan only 40-60 ppb. Here we report the development in our center of a fast operating NO2 sensor based on amorphous tellurium layer of nanometric thickness operating at room temperature. Here you can see the schematic of sensor design. It consists of a substrate, silicon substrate, covered by a silicon oxide and two platinum electrodes. Between these two platinum electrodes, an amorphous nanometric layer of tellurium is grown. What's important here that this layer should be, the thickness of this layer should be less than the thickness of platinum electrodes. This technology process is necessary to have at least atomic force macroscopy. Here are results from of Dr. Branişte, which help us to make this technology. In such circumstances, at contact can arise the regions with an extreme high concentration of majority caries. So the quasi stationary level moves below the valence band edge of tellurium. And in such a way, a degenerate region of paired tellurium, that means metallic tellurium, can appear. The width of this layer can be controlled by gas adsorption. Here you can see the materials. In our case, to fabricate this sensor, we have grown this on the platinum, on the silicon seawater wafer, four platinum electrodes. This is the same micrograph of tellurium lava. You can see that it's really in amorphous state, confirmed also by XRD. Pattern. The ADX analyzers show the elemental composition in this on this sensor. The tellurium lava really is very low, is really thick, because the concentration of tellurium is only about 0.26 atomic percent. Now, sensing characterization. The following parameters were used for characterize this sensor. Sensitivity, response recovery times, dynamic range, selectivity, and long-term stability. Here on this picture is shown the calibration curve. That means the sensitivity of the sensor versus gas concentration. You can see that at low concentration, the sensitivity increases very sharply with increasing of concentration, of gas concentration. But finally, this curve tends to a saturation. That means that this sensor is very nice for detecting of low concentration of nitrogen dioxide, which is in the region of sub-ppb. The long-term stability the sensor have been tested during 3 months. Here you can see the resistance in air and in the atmosphere with NO2 by 3 months. You can see that really the stability is quite good and the sensor is practicable. Now, dynamic response. The response of the sensor is very fast and consists of around several seconds, a few seconds. Here you can see the sensors with response of about 5 seconds. The recovery process is also high. It's a little bit higher than the response. It's also in a range of seconds and consists of about 60 seconds. The transition characteristics are shown here. That means the response of the sensor at the pulses of toxic gas with different concentrations. You can see that the response follows the schedule of gas application. The response time is very fast, but the recovery is a little bit lower. The analysis of these characteristics show the response time decreases inversely proportional with increasing of NO2 concentration by this law, the phenomenological law, that in principle coincide with results of Langmuir's theory. Effect of temperature. Here you can see the variation of the resistance and sensitivity of the sensor with increasing of temperature. The conclusion is that the temperature does not much influence both the sensor resistance and sensitivity. The effect of 1 degree centigrade temperature change is 15 times smaller than the effect of 1% of NO2 concentration change. Important is for room temperature detecting the effect of humidity. This picture shows the influence of humidity on the resistance on basal line. That means the sensor in air and sensor in a mixture of air with nitrogen dioxide. This is one part per million of NO2. Both these characteristics increases with the increasing of relative humidity. But because this increasing is different, the sensitivity increases twice by increasing the humidity from 10 to 90 relative percent of relative humidity. Interfering effect. It means response sensor to different gases. This diagram shows the response sensor. You can see that the response is strongly differs from value and direction. For instance, the sensor decreases by exposure to nitrogen dioxide and carbon dioxide, but increases by exposure to hydrogen sulfide, ammonia, propylamine, and water vapors. Vapors such as ethanol, acetone, toluene do not interact with these developed sensors. Important for us was the interfering effect of two gases, other main gases together exhaust for combustion. This picture shows the interfering effect. Two concomitant pulses of gases of 1 ppm of NO2 and 1000 ppm, 10,000 ppm of CO have been applied. And the response of sensor to CO2 is by 4 orders of magnitude smaller than the response to NO2 obtained by the same sensors operate under identical experimental conditions. Mechanism of sensors. The listed experimental results show that in sensing mechanism, in sensors mechanism take part both the surface phenomena and the contact phenomena and this structure. Here you can see the Venn diagram of this platinum amorphous tellurium platinum structure. This structure comprises a thin insulated layer originated from the microscopically roughness, which can be transparent for caries due to tunneling effect. But the platinum tellurium junction belongs to one where the adjacent two contacts region become degenerate with the Fermi level lying below the valence band of the tellurium. Such an unusual situation occurs because the band bending exceeds the forbidding gap of tellurium. When the such device is introduced into NO2 environment, the absorption of gas molecule occurs under, in the contact gaps. Absorbed in the contact gaps of a polarized NO2 molecules, align them in direction of contact field, resulting in modulation of drop and the tellurium surface work function. The last lead to increasing of portion of tellurium, which is turned into p-type metallic tellurium, this portion. In other words, such a transition operates as a switcher, which turns the semiconducting tellurium into other materials, into metallic tellurium with higher conductivity. Now, comparing with Langmuir's theory of absorption. The classical Langmuir theory of absorption is the rate of surface coverage by this equation, this formula. From this formula, this then is the surface concentration of adsorbed molecules, and N with the star is the surface concentration of absorption centers. It is seen that the surface coverage is proportional with number of gas molecules on the unit area. Consequently, the time derivative of the current has to diminish proportional with this with current change. On this picture, you can see the plot of experimental data. That means current derivative versus current change. And you can see that this picture depicts that this device, the developed device, does not follow the simple Langmuir's model of surface coverage. In principle, the Langmuir's model is realized only at long time exposure in this range. But during the tenth of second after the target gas is switched on, something is happened that results in a sharp boosting of the current flow through the device. That in principle confirms our model for adsorption in the contact gaps. Conclusions. Rapidly responding sensor for the NO2 detection at room temperature can be fabricated based on nanolayered amorphous tellurium grown between platinum electrodes. The NO2 sensing mechanism involves both the contact phenomena, platinum amorphous tellurium junction, which can comprise a degenerate metallic p-type tellurium caused by the high work function difference between contact materials that exceeds the forbidding gap of tellurium. Gas-induced modulation on the width of this degenerate region is assumed to be the reason for this essential diminishing of the both response and recovery times of the device. Thank you for your attention. If any question are, please, I'm ready to try to answer.
Thank you very much, dear professor, for your presentation. Dear colleagues, dear participants, If you have any questions, suggestions. Yeah, Professor, in this case, I will have a simple question. As one of the purposes of using such sensors is the measuring the air quality in rooms in the city. I mean, the measuring of concentration of exhausting gases from automotive industry. Have you tried to figure out how this the behavior of such sensors in other environments, namely the micro suspensions of metallic particles of or other particles presented in air?
Thank you for the question. Really, these kind of sensors have been tested in different environments for environmental monitoring and also by for exhaust of automobiles. But not directly this kind of sensor, because all the sensors have a long response time between 10 of seconds and minutes. But as I said at the beginning of my presentation, the concentration of this extremely toxic gas is very toxic, this gas. Therefore, it's necessary to measure a fast measuring of this of high concentrations. Therefore, this development is conducted to develop, namely to increase, or maybe to be exactly, to decrease the response time. And what we have at the moment, only we have patented this this device, not more. And I think that maybe in the future we'll try to propose to some industry. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your answer. And doubly, it's a very interesting research. As you know, these days in our city in Chisinau, the air was very, very polluted. And the index of pollution in the air was exceeding 165 units, which is very, very polluted. It's not recommended to walk, to go without a mask in the city. So thank you very much, Professor.